And posted. Published. Alright, cool.
Alright.
Just tweeted all that stuff.
Dude,
yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. This will be fun.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's
gonna You're just wigging out, yeah. You're ahead of all of us.
Literally.
Alright, I'm gonna go live, guys.
Okay.
Here we go. Opening video. Our voices can still be heard, so.
Hey guys, I'm Lindsay. You're watching Show Off Live.
You guys are the two last people on Earth who don't watch
yeah.
The Walking Dead.
Right? Yeah, never seen it.
Yeah. Now!
In my ear!
Here's my Dolly Parton impression. Oh, wait, it's gotta get my waist in there.
This is the Game of Thrones fire breathing trivia.
Yes, because I control the dead. That's why it's called Walking Dead. We're doing it live! A ton of albums are dropping today. I'm melting from those abs. You could cut a steak with those abs. Good morning, Facebook! Happy Friday! Oh, I mean, good morning, Facebook. It's me, Cersei. I have extensions put in because I flew all the way to Hollywood, and they told me that my boy hair wasn't cute enough for camera anymore, so I'm back to my old hair. Anyway, please welcome Show Off Live, Producer Paul!
Thank you. Thank you.
Lindsay cannot be here today, so I'm hosting in her place. And I'm going to burn this whole building down with my wildfire.
A little uncomfortable. A little, that's a terrorist threat right there,
Producer
Cersei.
Paul,
yeah.
Don't get on my bad side.
I don't know how to get on your good side, but we'll go with it.
Nobody does except for Jamie.
I'm actually frightened.
I wish you were my brother, then I would love you.
Making me real uncomfortable, Cersei. Real
Even
uncomfortable.
Weirder. You guys, it's Friday, it's almost 4th of July. Da-na-na-na-na-na-na. Please comment in the comment section below. I have my phone with me again, and I will be taking your questions, comments, shout outs, blah, 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 anything you want. If you notice, look at our new set.
Hell
There's
yeah.
There's so much room to dance.
All
crazy.
Right. Well, let's just keep you at the desk for now.
Well, I'll just stay. Yeah. Stay at your mark. Stay at your mark. Okay, we have a very special guest today, you guys. We have Lincoln Castellanos.
Woo!
Play the clip. Oh my gosh, you guys, we have him in the studio today. Please welcome my dear friend, Lincoln Castellanos!
Woo! Yeah! What's up, Lincoln?
Oh, Lincoln,
Where,
Lincoln.
Oh.
Lincoln, we're ready for you.
Yeah,
oh, sorry. Yeah. I was just waiting. The waiting room was crowded, so I just...
Oh, our green room.
Oof. I'm really glad Obama moved the needle on Cuba.
Oh,
this is really
yeah.
exciting.
Yes, yeah,
yeah.
yeah.
Good. Yes. I'm so glad that we have such good quality reading material for you.
I'm going to have to check that out after.
You guys, this is Lincoln. He is well known for his role as Tobias on Fear the Walking Dead. Let's have some shout outs here. You guys comment in the comment section below. We're going to do a little Q&A here, Lincoln. Is that okay?
That's fine. I'm not nervous at all. But
do you want me to
When
be
you
certain?
Say you're not nervous, it sounds
when
like
When I
you're...
say I'm not nervous... I'm nervous.
Okay, all right.
But I'm just trying
nervous.
Not to let people
But it's
know.
It's not because you're live. It's because you're standing next to kind of crazy person Cersei.
Don't tell her, but I'm scared.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
I'm
I just
you.
Want to
I'm
kill
you,
people
man.
All the time. I just am such a slayer. I need
slays.
A big goblet of wine.
That's what you
oh,
need.
Oh, come on
That's
now.
What, so Lincoln
You'd
is
be
a fan.
Slaying.
Yes, I need wine. Lincoln, you're a fan of both Game of Thrones and Walking Dead, correct?
I am indeed.
Perfect that you're here today for the Show Off Showdown. I can't wait to get into that. But first, let's talk about your role on Fear the Walking Dead.
Let's do it.
There is a theory that Tobias will be like the Morgan character on The Walking Dead in the first episode and makes a big return later in the series. What are your thoughts about that?
Well, I just think it's very humbling to receive such a really positive comparison to such a, you know, moral compass of a character. You know, Morgan has really become such an important part of The Walking Dead timeline. From the very first episode, he makes an impact, then he disappears for like two seasons, comes back for one episode, disappears for two more seasons.
Yeah.
Now he's a regular, but now he's the character that people turn to when there's so much, you know, like, there's so much, you know, being threatened in the Walking Dead world.
Totally.
And he stands for all the good still, despite all that.
Yes.
So I like that, and I think
that's why you got him on the chest there.
That's why.
Represent.
Yes, representing!
Yeah, a fan gave this to me at one of the conventions, so I'm proud of Warwick.
Awesome.
Hell yeah.
You know, Lenny James is a great actor, and it's a great character, and to say that, you know, people think that Tobias is like the same way. He'll make some kind of, you know, long-lasting impact.
Yeah.
It's humbling.
Yeah.
You know, and the whole experience has been a blessing. So.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
He seems like he's smart enough to survive the zombie apocalypse and meet up with them later. Like, he knew before everyone else.
And that's the thing. That's why he gets the comparison drawn, because he knew everything that the protagonist didn't.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know, Morgan filled in Rick, and then Tobias filled in Madison. And since then, she's used those.
That's an interesting parallel,
So we have some fans commenting here. Let's see. Stacy says, what happened to Lincoln's character?
What do you think happened?
That's a good question. Well, the one thing that is confirmed, and the showrunner Dave Erickson said it in an interview because it just kept getting brought up, he's not dead. So that much is certain. There was
Bring him back.
There was a few, like, you know, worried alarms, you know, going off in the first season, because there was like someone with a flashlight signaling a main character. Then they got X'd out, and everyone thought that that was Tobias. And I was like, it's the first I'm hearing of it. You know, I don't know if that's me. So the showrunner said, that's not him, and he's still out there.
Okay.
So I think it's just a matter, you know what? If you ask me for my personal opinion on it, you know, maybe it's not if he comes back, it's just when.
Yes.
Jennifer said, maybe he'll make an unexpected return.
Yep.
And that's the thing.
Yes,
Jennifer. That's what we're hoping for.
I think we're hoping for that for sure. Let's see. Still waiting to watch season 2 of Fear the Walking Dead, says Scott Bishop.
What are you doing? Get on it.
Catch up.
Come on.
This is a good time. We're in the mid-season hiatus.
Exactly. You got some time before August 20-something. Yeah.
Scott Bishop also chimed in, bring him back.
Okay, okay.
You got the chant going everywhere.
Guys, let's get a hashtag going, bring Tobias back. Yeah. I'm sure it was already going, but
let's have a hashtag, right? Team Tobias?
Yeah. Team Tobias?
Yeah, that's the crazy thing. You know, I wasn't really I wasn't the biggest user of Twitter before the show, but I thought, you know what? I do love watching Walking Dead.
Yes.
Occasionally I would tweet to the show, let me at least do it since I'm on the companion series, and it's just taken off since then.
Yeah.
It's weird. It's like the whole experience is just surreal.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I'm a huge fan. I've been, you know, I've been watching Walking Dead even before there was something to watch. I was reading the comics in school.
Yeah.
Wow, so, nice. Yeah. OG.
Very cool, man.
OG.
Original fan there. Let's see. Amanda Hayward said, yes, Walking Dead, Team Tobias. Jennifer Renson said, looking forward to the show every day. SHOWoff got a shout out. Thank you, Jennifer, for tuning in. Ooh, look, we're getting so many like buttons. Look at that.
Oh my goodness.
Are loving it. Okay, so yes, click the like button. We love those little bubbles. I love when they come up. They make me happy.
And then they float on the screen like
they
this.
Float, yeah.
With a few like happy faces.
And some hearts. Like one heart.
Do you ever get any like angry faces? Like, why am I not on the show?
Not yet, but now that you said it, we'll probably get some.
We'll get that one person who's like, I'm gonna do it. Or like the crying faces. I'm like, ruining lives.
Oh no, it's so sad.
Yeah. It's the saddest show. Well, it will be since Queen Cersei's on today. Oh gosh, that's crazy. What if I just lost my mind on live television? Okay, also Lincoln, can you tell us about the Walker Stalker conventions that you attend? You went to one in Chicago and Nashville, right?
Yes, I've been attending the Walker Stalker conventions since last summer in Philadelphia. So about once a month, the Walker Stalker conventions, they make their way to different exposition centers, you know, in the main cities. So last month I was in Chicago. Next weekend, for the 9th and 10th of July, I will be in New Jersey.
New Jersey!
Hey, New Jersey
Expo Center, yeah.
Guys,
so.
Meet Tobias, meet Lincoln in New Jersey.
And you'll also get to meet, what's great is you also get to meet all the other Walking Dead cast members.
Yeah, that's so,
so
cool.
For me to be there, you know, I wasn't much of a, look, I was a little naive and I thought, Comic-Con was the only con
thing, you know? And then you found out about SantaCon.
And then, SantaCon. We just had CatCon
last week. We did have CatCon.
You know, there's a con for everything.
You were there for that, right?
It was a big fan.
Producer Paul definitely was there for that.
I was definitely there for CatCon.
We might have seen each other. But I had my cat mask, so you didn't see me.
Me too.
Oh, really?
We were probably hanging out all day. We
probably were, man.
Just two kitties hanging out in the streets of probably San Diego.
How weird can we take this show? We'll see.
But it's fun. You know, the con experience has been such an exciting new part of this whole ride that I'm on. So to, meet fans and me be a fan too, it's like loving a band and then being backstage and then all of a sudden the band's like, hey, come play with us.
Yeah.
That's what it feels like.
You're like, yes, I will.
Yes, yes, yes. Awesome. Kylix is like putting his arm around me like, hey, buddy. And like, and then Josh is taking a selfie and he never texts me it. You know,
come on,
Josh.
I'm still waiting, man.
Text him your selfie. God.
Everyone's cool. So next weekend I'll
be there.
Except
for Josh.
Yeah.
Josh, and he's
selfie hoarder.
Yes, hoard selfies of Lincoln. God. Okay, let me just check in. Sean says comics are better.
Whoa, what do you think about that?
Whoa.
Well, you know what?
Whoa, Sean.
You know, shots fired. Yeah.
Shots fired.
Listen, it's one thing. You know what? I think the show does an admirable job of staying true to some, you know, storylines.
Because you read the comics, so you know.
Yeah. And then, when necessary, it takes a step out of that, you know, trajectory and creates a new different path.
Yeah.
Because if it was all just, precisely based on the comics, everyone who reads the comics would know what to expect in the show. How much fun is it going to be? Look, even Game of Thrones.
That's what I was going to say. Game of Thrones does that. A lot of people have read the books.
It kind of steps away.
You got
especially
it.
More so in this last season. The book hasn't even been written or come out yet. Season 6 was just all kind of...
Let's create something new.
Yeah.
Which was fun. I liked that because all my friends who had read the books of Game of Thrones, I was like, you don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
We're on the same page. You're just as dumb as me.
Yeah, you're in the dark like me.
But what's cool about Walking Dead is, you know, the show stays true to the comics when it needs to for like really important storylines that have a lasting effect for like many, many issues.
Mm-hmm.
And then sometimes it like switches like the way a character dies and then it creates more of an impact on the show than it did in the comic, you know, so like
for sure.
So they have their strengths and different parts that they play.
Hey, Grace Warner says she met you at Walker Stalker Con in Atlanta in 2015.
Awesome. I hope you're there this October.
Yeah.
After New Jersey, I'm going to Boston and then it'll be Philadelphia and then Atlanta. Yeah,
Atlanta's got to be huge. That's like the mecca, right?
Yeah,
it's the
that's
hub.
Where they shoot
it's
the show.
Main hub for walk. So everyone's there. Andrew Lincoln will be at the Atlanta one, and he doesn't do many.
Yeah,
he doesn't do
That'd
many.
Awesome.
Actually, when I went to London for the first convention they had in London,
that's
was
where
there.
I'm from. How funny!
Yeah.
Oh wait, no, I'm from King's Landing. Sorry,
close enough.
But my voice. Sounds like.
Anyway. Yeah, it's just a quick commute between the two.
Dang it.
I saw Andrew Lincoln there, and people take photo ops with him, and I had already met him once before. I was like, I don't want to take time away from somebody. And I reached in my pocket to grab a marker, and I had a $5 bill, and I was like, I ran to the photo op, and I was like, hey, you know, I met him again. I was like, hey, could you mind holding this, in our picture?
Yeah. The Lincolns.
So it's one Lincoln with Mr. Lincoln holding a Lincoln.
Brilliant.
I'm cheesy.
Cheesy is awesome.
It's really
cool. Oh, man. We will find that picture. I've seen that picture.
I think you have
seen that picture. And,
I'll tweet
we'll
it
post
again
it.
After,
yeah, we'll post it after this feed because it's a great... Great picture.
It's a great family, you know. All the Walking Dead cast members are a huge family, and you know I see that too with the Game of Thrones cast. Anytime they're
sure.
doing press and
it.
Stuff, they're all hanging out.
Yes, they're all best friends. Yeah. It's really fun.
Yeah. And then they get to chop each other's heads off.
It's all all in a day's work.
You know. You know that's what true friends do.
Yeah.
They stab each other in the back. Whoa, that's not great. That's not what a great friend does.
One final question for Lincoln.
Great.
You can answer in one word, no explanation. We want your prediction. Who does Negan kill? Or if it's two people, you could say that.
Daryl?
All right, you okay. Heard it first.
Daryl?
Daryl? also, Alina says, Walking Dead is awesome and is literally my life. Thank you, that is all. Thank
concise.
You.
Yes.
Thank you, that is all. yes, so stay tuned because we have a whole show. Our whole show is Walking Dead versus Game of Thrones. If you're just tuning in, Show Off Live, we have Lincoln Cassidy.
Oh, come on.
Oh, hey.
Castellanos.
You got it. Don't worry.
You know, like, when
I
get nervous?
You,
I get nervous.
I believe in you. You can say words correctly.
Lincoln Castellanos.
Yes.
Castellanos.
Nothing was wrong about either of those.
Lincoln Castanoodles. It's like all wrong.
Did you say Castanoodles? I've never heard
pasta
that.
Castanoodles. I'm like, #Castanoodles.
Castanoodles.
Lincoln Pastanoodles.
Now some noodles.
Hey, my name is spelled really weird and it always gets butchered, L-Y-N-D-S-I, so I sort of relate.
Yeah. Sort of relate. Yes, it's hard.
Because I'll see it all whack.
Well, no, yeah, our last names are different, you know.
Yeah.
It's the struggle.
It's the struggle.
#The struggle.
Yeah.
On that note, let's begin our show off showdown.
Woo!
Producer Paul, join me. And now it is time we are going to do Game of Thrones vs. The Walking Dead. We will be splitting into teams. Obviously, Lincoln and Producer Paul will be on Team Walking Dead. And I had to call in special reinforcements to be on my team. Tommen? Tommen?
Hello.
Tommen?
Hello. Well, it's getting real.
Getting really
nervous.
Yeah.
We're ready.
We're ready. So join us up here. Let's get close. Is everyone in frame? It is Game of Thrones versus Walking Dead. I'm borderline Australian right now with my accent. Don't judge me. Cersei is a world traveler.
So let's break it down what this segment is. We are finally determining what is the better show. We've broken it down into five categories we're gonna do for you. We're gonna have clips from both shows, and we're gonna battle it out. Which is the better show, The Walking Dead versus Game of Thrones?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Let's begin.
So we're starting off with category one. Which show has better zombies? Because both shows have zombies.
I know what the answer is.
Me as well.
Let's play the clip.
All right, so first up, we have Game of Thrones. The Game of Thrones zombies.
Mm-hmm. I think it's clear.
Clearly terrifying, yes. Children zombies are scary, right?
Humanoid ice creatures, okay? They were created to protect the children of the forest, the White Walkers. We vote Team White Walkers.
Okay,
I have a quick question, though. Isn't this like the first time we see a zombie attack like that in Game of Thrones?
It might have been the very first time. Like them, are they eating him at the end? Like, or her?
I think so. But the bigger question is, how often have we seen that on the show?
It's true. Yeah.
So
we have a great clip from The Walking Dead. I think you're gonna recognize this zombie.
I think so.
Let's see what it is. Disgusting! It's the well zombie, just
hideous.
Bloated, like waterlogged, decaying corpse.
It's a staple for Walking Dead. That zombie
in half.
That walker, yeah.
This is what I'm saying. Now look,
disgusting.
The children are terrifying, but I'm so sick of in horror movies. It's such a cliche now to have the scary children, right? Like, come on, do something original.
Yeah.
Children are the worst.
Yeah. Right. So I say Walking Dead wins.
Yeah, they just have more zombies, more consistent.
Yeah, and that's just one. There's tons of gross ones like that.
Yeah, there's tons of walker
types.
Yeah,
that was really
nasty. Let's go to the scorecard and see who wins.
Scorecard.
The Walking Dead. Hell yeah.
Kill yourself, Tom, and kill yourself.
Whoa.
Not yet.
That's only the first round. You're the worst mother. You're the worst mother.
There's still some game left.
Don't cry. Get on screen. I need you. Support me. I'm your mother. Okay.
All right. Now to our next round. Round two is pyrotechnics.
Oh, we got this one in the bag.
I forgot my sunscreen.
Let's take a look at our clip.
Let's see Game of Thrones.
Even I will say, that's pretty explosive.
That's pretty crazy.
High fives all around. I mean, that was my doing. That was my doing.
Sure.
I planned that. So
good for you.
You must be proud.
I am.
Whoa. Whoa.
I killed your wife, your high sparrow, but I did it for you, Tommen.
That must have been hard for you to watch.
She killed your spirit, most of all.
I vote Game of Thrones because the effects are perfect. What?
Clearly.
We haven't even seen the other one.
I know, but we don't need to see the other one. Fine, show it.
Yeah, well, let's go to the Walking Dead
experience. Whoa.
Not as good. Okay, all right. That was the very first season, right?
It was the first season, and granted, Walking Dead isn't known for its pyrotechnics.
Right, yeah.
You know, there's a lot of other stuff going on in Walking Dead besides big explosions.
We don't need this round. Let's go to the scorecard.
Scorecard, please. Oh!
Bang, bang.
Thank you.
Fair assessment.
Honestly, I give it to them for that one. Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
We're going on to category 3. Gore.
Oh.
Come on now.
Whoa.
Come on now.
Yikes. All right. Let's start with our clip first because queens always go first.
Elia Martell. I killed her children. Then I raped her. Then I smashed her head in like this.
Traumatizing. Oh, yeah. Really disturbing.
Oh,
yeah.
I was like, what? But I watched that.
I know. That was one of those things where you're out of your seat and just like, no! What is happening?
I was with some friends who had read, one of them read the book. They're like, hold on. Just wait. And then he just waited for our reaction like, oh my God.
He didn't see it coming.
Hey.
Get it? Because his eyes were blasted out of his head.
He had no eyes.
Yeah, we get it, Queen.
Laugh, Tommen!
Mother.
Next.
Let's see our clip. That was, of course, Noah being torn to shreds in season 5.
Awful, yeah, horrible.
So here's my argument. Yes, the mountain also tore Oberyn Martell's head to shreds, but did he eat him afterwards?
No.
I rest my case. Go to the scorecard.
True.
Yeah!
There it is.
Yes.
That was close. All right. That was close. My British accent is getting so Kate Winslet right now. All right, the next category
is fights. I'm making sound effects. They're probably unnecessary. All right. Where did
play
those come
clip.
From?
Play our clip.
Go for it.
I loved it.
Yeah.
Oh, it's just such a jolly good time.
Okay.
Headbutting Lady Brienne. There's nothing better than headbutting a lady.
It's a good fight. Truth be told, it's one of the most memorable fights.
It is one of its series.
Two beloved characters, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know who to root
let's
for.
Let's see what she was. I saw that exact same fight outside a bar last Saturday.
Okay.
I'm bored to tears.
You know what, Cersei? You know what? Look,
bored to tears.
Headbutt all the way.
There was a few headbutts
in
there.
Game of Thrones has sword fights.
Okay.
That was Australian.
Look, we're talking
get out.
sword fight? Fist fight. Yeah. When it comes down to the nitty gritty, sometimes this is all the fight that matters.
Yeah, that's right. You know what that fight reminded me of? Did you ever see the chicken versus Peter Griffin on Family Guy? They're just like rolling off cliffs and stuff. Like, come on, man, mano
a
mano.
Is that not the most epic fight in all animation history?
Listen, if you play that clip, I'll vote for that one right now.
That's true. That is
Family
the best
Guy
fight
takes
on TV history. Yeah.
All right, let's see.
Come on.
Come on.
Oh, what?
Yes, all right.
People gotta have their swords. That's fair.
Yeah.
I don't have any pockets.
All right. So I'll put it back.
So we're tied.
Yeah, we're tied. Going into the final round, deaths.
Deaths.
Ooh. Death. What? Bring it on. It's my favorite.
Oh, I got cut in half. It died.
That was a killer graphic.
It was
Get
a
it?
Killer graphic. Oh.
All right. We have a,
The Lannisters send their regards.
I can't believe I let my son watch that.
That's really terrible.
I should have covered his eyes like a good mother.
Honestly, those are all characters that, you know, if you watch the show, you love and have grown attached to. So to see them go like that,
that was
Hodor,
crazy.
Everyone at the Red Wedding, that's tough to beat.
The Red Wedding.
And the neck.
Yep. Yeah.
Always go for the neck.
Thank you.
But.
That's all right, so the difference here is that's all characters that you loved on Game of Thrones, and those were mostly characters that you hated. It was the governor, it was Sam, the most annoying child in TV history, and Beth, she's
They were eating their food.
I will, for the sake of it, make my case for why Walking Dead deaths are more meaningful.
Let's
give it
hear
to
it.
Me. Give it to
Whatever
me.
The results may be, I just want to say Tyrese's death
was
a whole episode.
True.
And you have so many other main characters that have gone. You know, you got Herschel, you have Shane, you
Huge
have Dale, and the whole ending to the finale of this last Walking Dead season was who's dead?
Yeah, it's true.
And that's going to have such...
The question of Game of Thrones is who's not dead, okay?
We killed Ned Stark
right after the audiences fell in love with him. We just killed him right off in the first few episodes. It was heartbreaking. And that was when I was totally like, what show am I watching? and we kill everyone that you love, that you hate. Mostly that you love. It's such a mess of death.
I know. Is that a gimmick, though, you wonder?
Yeah, exactly.
Is it just like, ooh.
Like, watch this.
Oh my god!
Wow.
That weird replaced window right there.
He
just splatted on the screen.
Wow, that was cold, sir.
Now you rub all over it.
That's cold. Cold dedication to my
And the winner is
Yes!
Oh come on!
I kill my children for points.
You gotta
to win.
Be
she did it for the win.
To win.
All right. Who's deciding?
I'll take that. Part.
All right.
Look who's queen now. Also, I'm getting too into it. All right.
Still, I will just say that category out of all of them is the most debatable.
That's the most toss-up. There's
a fair argument to be made for both. But okay.
But here's the thing. So I don't know who decided all that, but we're giving it to the fans now. We have a show-off poll. That we're gonna be running all July 4th weekend that you guys can vote on which is the better show in all those categories. And then on Tuesday,
tune
back in and we're gonna announce who the real winner is because I think the fans gotta decide, right?
Yes.
Right?
These are fan shows.
Yes.
Yes. And while we are fans and while we love to show off, it is your turn to show off. So make sure you vote this weekend and let us know who you think Game of Thrones. All right, I'm checking in.
Yeah,
who's Stacey said, I'll give you the Red Wedding, but sheer volume of The Walking Dead and the Fire Factor combined give The Walking Dead the edge.
Hmm.
Good point, Stacey, but I disagree because I'm Cersei Lannister. I want to say, is it Alina? Is that who we want to say?
Alina,
right? Hi, Alina. Walking Dead is better in all categories, and she wrote it in all caps.
Yeah, I think I know who's winning this poll.
Alina, I will find you. Mark my words. Cersei Lannister.
Should, now you're threatening our fans.
You should move.
Cersei was. What a also schizophrenic. Jumping in and out of character.
To me, it was Cersei.
It's a weird day.
It's me, Lindsay. It's me, Cersei. Okay. All right, you guys. So Game of Thrones won that. And in your face. So now we're moving on to Caption This.
A trivia.
No, you're
trivia.
Right.
Trivia. We got our whole, it wouldn't be.
We got a, duh. Okay, I got to bring my son back from the dead. Red Witch.
Oh.
Here he is.
Oh. So you can just jump into any old character then. That's fine.
Because I need him for trivia.
That's fine.
All right. Now we are playing, I'm sorry for that hiccup. We are playing SHOWoff Live trivia here.
It wouldn't be SHOWoff Live if we weren't going to make a mess.
Here we go.
So here's the deal. We're playing SHOWoff Live trivia, Game of Thrones versus Walking Dead. All the questions are answered both. They could be The Walking Dead or Game of Thrones. So this is what, you guys are obviously Team Game of Thrones. And so if you guys get a question right or we get one wrong, you get to make us into White Walkers with some flour. Or just me, actually. You could
yes,
just throw that
Lincoln,
on.
Lincoln, you're exempt.
Your shirt is way too nice. A fan gave that to you.
I will we're not gonna feel bad for you.
Yes. Yeah, no, please do. Yeah, feel free to feel bad for me. But if we get one right or you get one wrong, we are going to make you into zombies because these are zombie guts, silly string, purple and red. So. And maybe we should just do it to you because you're evil and why should I just get it on my team?
That sounds good.
Yeah.
He just came back from being dead.
That's true.
You kind of killed me. I think you should take one for the team now.
And we're going to move these guys.
Oh yeah, we're going to get the lovely guitars out to the shot so we don't gut them and White Walker them.
Yes.
Yeah, right. I just miss producer Paul and land right on the guitar.
You're not gonna be throwing anything this way.
I'm gonna throw it this way. Okay. Oh, yeah, that's
right.
Confident.
That's right. That's but still, confident. I'm gonna save the guitars.
All right, our friend here, Orlando, is going to read our questions. Oh.
Hey.
Hey.
My sword is trying to find its way back to me. Lincoln.
I'm gonna stick to my knife.
Stick to your knife.
Exactly like a White Walker.
Are we still doing crazy noises, people? Static is so bad we can barely hear you.
Oh no.
What do we do?
Well, we just gotta go and
fix
the recording. It's fine.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
All my meters are set.
Okie dokie. All right, we're just gonna keep going.
Ready? All right.
Okay, who is the only character who has not been held prisoner? Jaime Lannister, Ned Stark, Daryl Dixon, or Carl Grimes?
What? That's my word!
That would there you be go. That would be Carl.
Carl is correct.
Oh,
yes! Thank
no.
you. I was going to say Daryl, too. I'm glad I leave.
No, Daryl was held captive by Dwight.
Oh!
Oh,
yes.
No!
Which color do you want?
I'll take purple.
Okay.
Do this.
You can step back and be like, I'll take this one. Try not to get the wig. I mean my hair. Oh, no.
Ready.
You ready?
Let's do this.
All right, you're getting double.
Zombie.
I'm getting double.
Ready?
Yeah.
Two, go. One, go. Yes! Yes! Ow. Yes! Oh, come on! No, that didn't go in your mouth.
Yeah, we didn't spray it in your mouth.
You basically spoon-fed
flour. I will get my revenge, son. Yes.
I got your shoulder.
It's in my mouth, it's in my nose. It smells so good. This must be so good for our lungs. It's straight poison.
Don't try this at home.
Yeah. Oh no, I'm covered in zombie guts!
This one's really smart.
Wow, alrighty then. All right,
next
question.
Next one?
Yeah. Dang it. All right.
Good Who is the only guys. Character to not watch their father's head get cut off?
Ooh.
Sansa Stark, Arya Stark, Beth, or Robb Stark?
Robb Stark.
Robb Stark is correct.
Yes! Woohoo! Yeah!
No!
You want to switch it up?
No.
Okay, okay, okay.
What? You're like basically clean now.
I don't know, he just wrote it on.
Yeah, come on.
He's got a shower after this. Yeah. Okay.
Let's just go for it.
We good?
Yeah.
Ah! Oh, yeah, they didn't get my face! In the
Had to. Alright.
Ooh, it's cold.
This is the last,
why is it cold?
Last one.
Last one.
Last one.
Question.
Alright,
here we go. Which character never uses a weapon to kill people or zombies? Carl Grimes, Cersei Lannister,
Herschel? Yes!
Okay.
We only need two answers.
Never uses a weapon.
Don't
I'm just
look at
buying time.
Come on, go!
Come on, people!
What?
People. Uses a weapon to kill people or zombies.
Can I say it before she says it?
I don't.
Yeah, she
I
has
don't
an
make
answer.
The rules.
Come on.
It's Cersei.
We were gonna say that.
I was gonna. It's me.
Yes.
It's Woo! Cersei.
But you didn't. I don't know what you're waiting for.
I needed time to think about it.
Between the two of them, though.
I couldn't remember.
She's never killed someone with a weapon.
No.
No, she always makes other people do it.
Yeah, right. She makes others do
it. I choose violence.
I choose violence.
Oh, no.
That other people do the violence.
That other people do the violence. That's why it made me think she said, I choose violence. She's never actually done it. Because I didn't keep my hands.
Indirect.
All right, enough about
like,
you,
it's like involuntary manslaughter, you know.
Ready? 3, 2, 1. Oh, my God, I shot you by accident. I'm a bad shot.
Hey.
Oh, my God. This thing's like off.
Cold.
Oh. All right, that's enough.
I'm gonna write my last name on your back. Okay?
Oh,
Castellanos.
Right. Was that right? Did he say it right?
Yeah. I'm taking your job.
Yes.
Well, that's.
That was for good luck.
For good luck.
If you can do it, then.
No. Oh no! Don't. No. Don't you dare.
I'm too nice.
Too nice. He sprayed me in the ear. My wig is. I mean, my ear is covered.
All right.
My cool. natural hair. It's covered in silly guts. Silly guts. All right, so I think you guys won.
I think we did, yeah.
Yeah.
That one
so,
we did.
Wow, yes. Walking
nice.
Dead.
Nice game, Walking Dead.
I don't think you looks like a winner.
Great. Yeah.
You know what, Simon? Go jump out another window.
Yahoo!
All right, caption this now, right?
Caption this. Let's do caption this. Sorry if the audio is still cuckoo nutso. It's not. We love ya. Covered it. You know what's kind of cool about
Coachella
hair. All right, have a few of the entries, Paul. Look great. Look fantastic. So yesterday we had this gentleman, feel free to join me up here. It's teacher's reading to our fans who participated. We had some great captions today. So let's start with Jordanara. Now, why did you go and do what I specifically told you? Well, I'm messing that up. But I'm messing that up. You know why? I'm getting high off the gut here. Yeah, can you read it? We
okay.
can read.
Jordan, all right. Now, why did you go and do specifically what I told you not to?
Oh, he's a professional. Oh, my God. Yay, Jordan. Great. Thank you. He said, winter's coming, Sam, and you know what? He's a big. Carol's just
want that.
You don't want those? Those are poison? I like this one. Big boy and big boy. Your mom and I went in that Netflix and chill in sleep. That's awesome. All right, so we got a job and plus Dave Phillips, Jay Gerback, Big Boy, Larry J, Jennifer Redson, Jay, John Austin Sanchez, Julio Melendez, Paul.
So follow me on that adventure Sunday night.
Yes, and watch Roadies, yes.
Yes, and so it's Lincoln the Actor for Twitter and Instagram. Just
great.
Lincoln the Actor.
Lincoln the Actor.
Easy.
Perfect.
Simple.
Easy.
Awesome, yeah. We love it. Yep. Tommen, you can kill yourself now.
Oh, thank you.
Again, go die.
Thank you so much for tuning in. We will see you on Tuesday. We'll see you later. Bye, show us
bye. Bye, guys.
Are we good?
All right.
Oh man!
The audio fixed
it
itself,
and then
what again?
Turn the air on. Sarah, turn the air.
Maybe it's
when
that.
When you hand
the air, we need fresh air and
off.
Air.
So
oh, weird.
You said the audio was messed up.
I just
up.
Put your batteries
talking
in.
About.
It's I don't know why it keeps cutting out.
So it was your mic?
This was shutting off. Yeah. And so whenever this shuts
I
off,
just
it throws the audio
off.
Apparently.
Yeah.
Well,
sad.
I hope that's it because now
going.
We pinpointed it, but still that sucks.
It was fine and then
yeah.
It got bad? Is that
well,
what happened?
Well, I dialed back the overall volume so I thought maybe four people
yeah.
Screaming.
Yeah.
It was
yeah.
Just making a clip.
Yeah.
Can we get a photo of me, Lincoln, and Tom?
Let's get the air off.
Yeah.
Let's get the air off. Wait 10 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
just gonna trail flour wherever I go.
Yeah, you might as well just go in the kitchen and make something.
I know, yeah. Just start whipping up.
Yeah, you're out of batteries.
I don't know how that could be.
So that's what it is.
That was great. People would love it. Like, that was my most comments I've seen come in for asking you questions. Fans. Yeah, you brought your fans, so that was really cool.
We love your
fans.
Yeah,
I was excited about it.
Yeah.
That was a lot of fun.
They were really cool and like commenting and stuff.
Yeah.
So we'll fix that audio thing and then post the, because we record it too, so it'll be fine.
Perfect.
Today. Yeah. So what we should probably do is post something on the page. We should be like, sorry about audio issues, we'll post the full show, right? Because like if fans are like, what the hell?
Yeah.
What if we were like, hope you caught that spoiler that Lincoln dropped?
That's
true. But from what I saw, people like stuck around too. So it wasn't, weren't really like dropping off. So
you are keeping our fans in there.
Yeah.
That's all you, man.
This is a fun show, man. You guys have a really fun setup.
Thanks, man. Yeah, come back anytime.
Yes.
Yeah, it'll be fun. That'd be really great.
That's so cool that you're doing so much traveling and everything.
It's exciting. Because I wasn't really much of a traveler.